By the way, Pana is always looking for volunteers for the fire department. Now, Jim, what are the criterias for being a volunteer at the fire department?
Well, for the city of Pana, they require a background check. Of course, every city municipality around probably does the same thing. Beside that, the person applying, now this is male and female. We've had several females on the fire department over the years. You must be 21 years of age and under 45. The other way to get on the volunteer fire department is at the age of 14, you can join the Boy Scout Explorer Post, which trains these kids to be firemen. They learn to do everything that the firemen do, and under certain legal, through the Boy Scouts, conditions, they are allowed to fight fire. Now they can run handle what we call an exposure line. In other words, you got a house on fire, so you want to put water on the house next door. They can handle that line. And these kids train, they learn all the equipment, where it is, how it's used. They go through first responder classes, become first responders. With the Pana Fire Department, because we do run EMS now, that's probably 2/3 of our calls every year is running backup for the ambulance. And with a small town, especially after COVID, it's hard to get volunteers to run EMS. Well, it's run through the fire department, but it's free. You don't get paid for it, it's free. And it's usually one or two guys takes our Suburban out, which is fully equipped. It has all the equipment that an ambulance has, but it's non-transport. We cannot transport, but we can stabilize and keep a person stabilized until an ambulance from another town can come, which is something that we needed a long time ago that we got started in the early 70s doing. So when you first get on, you have to be qualified to run EMS. In other words, you have to take a first responder course because everybody works EMS. And that also helps our grants. In the last 10 years, 15 years, our EMS calls has upped our call. When I started, it was 50, 60, sometimes. You got 70, 75 fire calls or rescue. That was a lot of calls. We're running, I think last year they ran over 800 calls, and we've run up over 1,000 calls. But when you're applying for grants to get money from the state and from the federal government, this is used to generate that money. It puts you higher up on the this one deserves it, this one doesn't. The more you do to serve your community, the higher it puts you on that. And that goes in with this part where I said earlier about the $900,000+ that has been donated anonymously. I mean, we have three trucks in that firehouse right now that were totally donated by a benefactor. You're talking hundreds of thousands of dollars. We had a thing out where Mr. McCracken ran a fundraiser for new turnout gear for our fire department. And one lady, I told one of our secretary that I was going to see this lady, and I said, she's a very nice person, and she's been a big benefactor of our library for years. And she's asked me to come and get a check. I said, you watch. She's going to write us a check for $1,000. I opened the door. She told me to come in and sit down. She handed me a check for $10,000. I sat there and cried. I took it to Timmy and I said, sit down. He was standing up. He said, why did you get the $1,000? I handed him that check and he sat down and cried. But that's why I say the city of Pana, we go to school every year, Mike Foster and me and a couple other firemen, and we give classes to the driver's ed. And we talk with the kids about what to do if they're involved in a serious accident. And we give them the spiel of no drinking and don't use your phone, the whole bit. We've been doing that for 7 years, and in 7 years we haven't had a kid's vehicle accident, which was a major accident. They're listening. So there's a lot of things like that. But the fire department, we can use a few good men. It's like the Marine Corps motto. We're looking for a few good men, and that includes women, because we have had some good women that were on there.